Smash Four, Smash Four, zero commentative. I finished, I think, like 17th, having lost to Rags on the loser's side.
Oh, yeah.
Rags went off in that tournament and made 7th place, so you can't necessarily blame him, considering Rags was on one of the runs of his life.
You know, I'm very interested.
No. We're getting out of the past. We're into the present here.
Yes.
It is Wolf versus Fox in Smash Bros.
That's right. We need the time stone right here. Obviously, we're in present a day right here. But one of these two right here, obviously, looking to rewrite history. Now, I'm really interested to see how well these two are going to throw down in the neutral, because Snake, you know, Ally Snake specifically, can be a very zone-based character at times, but where Ally really shines is the craziness that he brings to the table when he gets in on these opponents. We've seen it with this Mario back in Smash 4. Snake's back in the business. We've seen him go for crazy stuff. Down throw. Reads which way you're going to tech roll. Goes for dare. Very quick move out of shield. I mean, Ally can just really beat you down, but at the drop of a hat, he can really switch out of that play style and then go for like Nikita gameplay, but he might not even get the opportunity right here. He's gonna have to play the comeback game. Dark, almost said Dark Wizzy, Wizrobe. Goddamn, too many Wizzes. All right, Wizrobe, going ham right here. Still coming off of that high that we've seen earlier versus Tweak.
And Wizrobe might just understand the movement options that Ally is gonna pick. As Snake, remember, Snake is pretty limited on his movement options in this game. Like, if he doesn't able to establish his little campground here with the up smashes, with the grenades, with the C4s, he's kind of limited in what he can do. Like, his aerials aren't necessarily safe. And on his way down to the stage, he can be absolutely abused. And let's see if Wolf can take advantage of that. But all right, the stanky leg of the up tilt gonna seal this stock right back.
That's right. Wolf, you know, very good character. Obviously, can bang in a neutral up close and personal, but can also play the long range game as well. Sturm using that that neutral special to kind of keep him out. But you know, you get too close on Snake, especially for a character like Wolf, who is historically very easy to combo. It goes for like a lot of short hop nairs, a lot of short hop forwarders. Sooner or later, you're going to get anti-aired with up tilt, and you're going to pay for it.
Nikita's coming out to play, but you know what? That was an interesting choice of up smash, but it turned out to be excellent. Remember that up smash from Wolf, it low profiles at the start and then it scoops up into the big hitbox. So it's just an excellent anti-air because it will not only answer the aerial options because of how active it is, but it'll just kind of dip under them at certain angles.
That's right. It's quite the scoop, isn't it? It's right up there like in terms of scoopage. Well, like Roy's up smash, Roy's up smash.
Mark and Lucina have kind of the same thing.
Yeah, where they kind of get the scoop plus the sprinkles in that situation right there.
That was almost some Galaxy Brain stuff, is that it? That grenade scooped into another grenade and the Cypher hit? Oh. Okay.
So I think he kind of faked them out right there. I think Wizro was actually expecting him to run to the ledge, go for Nikita. There it is that time, but wanted to make sure he was a little bit further away before he decided to go for it. He's out of a jump here. Has to elect to use side special, unfortunately. At the wrong moment, runs right into Nikita. Very smart gameplay right there from Alex to set up shop and not go out there.
Yeah, Ally making it happen for sure. And that's what we were talking about, is the disadvantage of Wolf can be a little bit abusable, right?
Uh-huh.
And specifically the recoveries. Oh. And now Smash Bros. Flapper coming to the aid of Ally here as he plants that C4. But what a great empty hop in with the up tilt.
Oh my gosh,
Dark Lizzy. I did. You got me
you
doing
did it,
dude.
Too. Sorry, no, right. this is light Wizro. This is the first, damn it. No, but yes, taking a page out of Snake's book, obviously getting up close to first and tossing on up tilt. You know, obviously giving him a taste of his own medicine here.
Mm-hmm.
All right, this time kind of trying to chop the lead in half. Find himself getting hit with the forward
Whoa,
tilt.
Whoa, that reflect was Galaxy Brain, dude.
It most definitely was. If I'm going off stage, damn it, we both are.
You're going to Nikita me, nah, son. You're going to Nikita both of us. That's better than just me.
There it is. Nice. Oh, using the active hitboxes of the up special right there to clank with it. I like that. Oh, don't jump in on me again. That is a Wolf thing, you know, and it's not. There's no disrespect to Wizro by any means necessary, but I get it. You get so much off a short, most characters do, but Will specifically gets a lot off a short hop nair, but you cannot do that around a Snake, especially one who likes to fight up close and personal like Ally. Ally will elect, if you really want to throw down, if you really want to put your hands on each other, we can make that happen.
I'll say it, up tilt from Snake might be the best anti-air in the game. And so if you get too happy with those jump-ins, that you are exactly correct. Ally gonna clutch that game off of that very last stock, last hit moment. And Wizrobe, though, definitely putting up a fight. I'm excited to see where this set continues as we go to Final Destination game two.
Look, if I know Wizrobe as good as I think I do, and I spend a lot of time with Evan from Smash Studios, he tells me a lot about Wizrobe. This guy does not take no for an answer, trust me. He has something up his sleeve right here. We might be in for a long one, but an exhilarating one. We're probably gonna go all five games, believe it or not. So ladies and gentlemen, let's strap it in. Let's get locked and loaded. Game number two, very, very close game. I was able to clutch out there in some of those final moments, but Wizrobe, we are here on Final Destination. The stage, historically very rough for Snake. Obviously, there are no platforms here, so with this in mind, Wolf has the ability to do things like this, just up tilt in the neutral and then try to read which way he's gonna go, do it again at low percent.
The disadvantage for both players on this stage is gonna be a little rough with no platform, obviously, too. to retreat to in any of these spots, and let's see if Ally can take advantage of it. Obviously, Wizrobe has a little bit of a safer time getting in with these situations, but Ally can also turn it around onto the Wolf if he is able to find the proper hits in that one, that jab and the dash away, that has to be conditioning for some kind of further situation in the corner that Ally is thinking of.
He is a mad
scientist in that regard.
Trust me, he most definitely, you know, remember back in Smash where we talked about the differences between the Mario, where we had like, you know, the up smash and roll heavy Marios, you know, like anti, then you had like the combo oriented ones like Zenyu. When it came to like trying to categorize Ally, we were just like, yo, this man is just crazy. Like, yeah. we literally can't pinpoint what it is he does or how he does it. He just sometimes conditions, you'll forget about it. You know, a minute into the match, 5 minutes later, that thing he conditioned you on, it wore you down.
Definitely a play in the player and not the game kind of situation.
Bruh, it's OD.
Ally is thinking, of all the habits you're doing right now, and okay, these back airs in a row, just gonna plant yourself and get a forward tilt from your troubles as Ally is starting to get some real work done in the second cycle with Wizrobe, but another scoop is gonna work out here for the melee bro.
Yeah, so I'm not exactly sure if he wanted to actually grab the grenade there in that moment or if he was actually trying to go for like a shield grab. Nonetheless, found himself unfortunately on the receiving end of an up smash, and as we know, that move hits like a ton of bricks and hurts all the same no matter how heavy you are. And Snake's a pretty heavy dude, mind you. I mean, he's carrying a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Dude is awfully heavy. Nice, tries to cook the grenade, catches him. Not quite. Off his feet. No B reverse. Actually elects to land with an attack. That could have been very troublesome for him. Had Wizrobe read it just a little bit quick, he could have ran up for a shield punish and really made his life difficult. Let's get it.
And now Wizrobe getting really good juggles in on this snake. Gonna force the Cypher out just to try and mix up one of your landing here. And okay, Ally is gonna find his way to Terra Firma here, and that is exactly where I will pick the stage. But then you got a little bit happy once more. Another jab, one for Ally, and that forces the jump this time.
Yes.
Which means, you know what's coming, that big up tilt.
Yes, and again, there is that condition we talked about. Sometimes jab one, you know, if you do it once, it's almost like fighting games. You use it to check your opponent, see if there's a pulse, see if they're still alive. In that case right there, nobody wants to get hit, historically, even going all the way back to Brawl, nobody wants to get hit with all three hits of Snake's jab. So more times now, the opponent's going to jump out at some of those later percents. Oh my goodness, speaking of jumping, jumps out, jumps back in, gets to Nair. You send a shot, oh, you're a little bit too low.
Wizrobe kind of getting away with murder there a little bit. I feel like I could have maybe gotten snuck out of Nikia there and something like that. Okay, looking at two frame with that down smash. That move is so violent. Wizrobe has to be very careful on this recovery. And nope, there comes the foot once more. You thought it was going to go up high. No, it's low this time, Rod.
Facing the feet, homie. Smart stuff. Sweeping the ledge. I mean, Wolf kind of getting a little taste of his own medicine, too. I mean, remember, Wolf can kind of do that same exact thing.
Mm-hmm.
So it just so happened he was on the receiving end at that moment. Ally moving up two games. Wizrobe putting up a very strong, very, very dominant fight. But you can tell there's just a couple exchanges where they're a little loose. He might want to tighten up because he's just getting outclassed. So let's see how Wizrobe's going to turn this one around. I want him to tap back into whatever it was that he was drinking or eating or smoking. I don't know what the hell he was doing earlier. Whatever he used to mount that victory there versus Tweak, because he really stuck it to him. He has to tap into that here versus Ally.
We'll have to see. Wizrobe is that kind of player. You know, this is, even if he just 3-0, loses 3-0, 3-0, this is by far his best Smash Ultimate tournament.
Yes, sir. Free.
Ever, right?
Free.
Because Wizrobe is not necessarily known for his ultimate plays, obviously known for his melee plays. But he's that kind of guy who, even if he loses out and gets ninth place, he's going to be disappointed. He's gotten this far. He wants that top eight.
He did not come this far to only come this far, Sturm. You know, when I seen him at Genesis, you know, I was walking with Evan. You know, we're going back to the hotel room. We seen him. He was out. I was like, you know what? He's out relatively early in some of these early Smash Ultimate Majors. But trust me, give it another 3 or 4 months. He's going to grind it out. He's going to learn every matchup that he can in a short time frame. And trust me, he's going to be just a mathematical machine monster here on the sticks. Let's see how well he mounts this victory here in game number 3. Ally already up 2 games. I mean, all he really needs is just one more.
Fun fact, I do believe this is a Smash and Splash 1 Grand Finals run back.
From which game?
Smash 4. Wizrobe played a pre-patch Sheik
during
that Customs tournament.
You are right. Oh,
versus Allies Mario, and it was a sight to see at that tournament.
I gotta be honest with you, Sturm. Smash Splash is known for bringing some of the most hype sets. I mean, we had Lucky and Loaf earlier. We had the Wizrobe set. You know, we obviously have Mars versus Seth just a little bit ago. Leo versus Pandaren, and obviously this one's shaping up to be just as legendary, if not more, depending on how it all finishes out. He's off stage, a little bit too far away to be directly on the money right there. The Nikita still gets the hitbox, but couldn't quite get it in the right direction. He's gonna go for back throw, of course.
This back throw puts Snake in a really precarious position as he goes high with this Cypher. Okay, not gonna cover the air just onto the center platform. Very smart from Ally to find that situation.
Oh.
Wow, what a great get-up attack read.
No, that's a very typical Ally thing, being able to just pinpoint where you're gonna go after that down throw. It's not enough to try to get like the re-grab situation locked in or the rollout in. Sometimes just let him stand up, you jump back, come in for dash attack, boom, you're still in an advantage.
That set up the backdoor KO from Ally the entire way through. Remember, he talked about how that's a classic. So many characters have backdoor KOs, including Snake. Snake, the character who has no lack of kill options, also needs to backdoor the KOs, of course.
You already
but
know, man.
Here is Wizrob answering right back. I believe that was backer of zone seal like a stock.
Okay, nice. Goes for the dare.
Excuse me? You challenged that?
I mean, this
challenging Wolf's up B is madman's
bro,
talk.
I don't
dude.
Know. I don't even know how Ally plays with balls that big, bro. I don't even know how he sits on the stage and plays sometimes like that.
It's so hard to win versus that move, but Ally doesn't care. He is up 2-0. He can go for some stuff.
That's right, but I really like this switch in pacing right here from Wizrobe. You know, and a couple of these other stages, and because he was getting punished, you know, we started to see a lot of short hop nair, a lot of short hop aerials come out, and Ally was certainly beating him to the punch. Really easy to dictate and pinpoint when Wolf is going to jump in a lot of situations. Very, very telegraphed. Bobsy was electing to kind of play the keep away game, try to slow things down, and also allowed Ally to kind of get hit with a lot of his own grenades, but unfortunately find himself again being just punished at the ledge of the stage. With that in mind, Ally closing it out, obviously going up another stock here, but 133%, I gotta say, Sturm, this man is on borrowed time.
Yeah, we'll have to see how long Ally can hang on here. He's kind of just taking his time on this platform, allowing some of those grenades to explode below it to kind of help him get down to Terra Firma here. And Ally not in too bad a shape at the moment. Okay, he's going to try to sneak an air dodge past. That's usually a situation where you'd see a Cypher come out from Snake, so I don't think Wizrobe was thinking of it. But, okay, what are you going for,
Wait, Ally? No punish? Oh, my God. I think he might have showed him some mercy, sir. This ain't Mortal Kombat. All right, you see the opportunity. You need to take it.
Yeah, Ally's going off stage. That means he's feeling some stuff here.
He's feeling very comfortable. Reflect, nice. Oh, drops it right in place. That was such a good option right there. Oh, and almost met with the even better odds and knew that he was going to try to back it right after that Nikita miss. Didn't quite scoop him up properly there with the up smash.
Dash attack claims the stage for Ally, but his back
goodbye.
Definitely get it done.
Can we talk about how just scary that was right there, Sturm? He went for like 1-2, didn't even finish the whole thing, tried to mix him up, stopped, and then went for the first hit of 4. So, I mean, he threw everything at him, and it still didn't work. Wizrobe right now with nerves of steel. Look at that. That's some fighting game stuff.
But Wizrobe not going to be disturbed by it. He gets a quick little down throw dash attack of his own. But you thought you could run to the platform? No, sir. That is Ally booking his ticket to Sunday Finals tomorrow on the winner's side.
There he is. 3-0. Very convincing 3-0 as well, too. Wizrobe obviously put up a very dominant fight, and we did see some adaptation on the go. But again, you know, there are a lot of snakes in the world.